have you agreed to?
Welcome, son.
So nice to see you, Hassan.
By the way, how is Fatima?
Fine, fine and dandy.
It's true.
Cut it out!
What are you grinning about, huh? Seems I get all the fools around here. Welcome, men.
Thank you, Sarge.
Friends, you're a Chanakkale now and at Arubun area. Our regiment commander is Colonel Mustafa Kemal Bey. Our regiment is the 77th, and we are the first company of the 1st Battalion. Our commander is Captain Dombe. Soon one morning, you'll be back in the trenches, and the enemy will be right ahead of you. Do not underestimate the English here out to kill. Don't tell me I did not warn you. If you don't cover all the time, he will get you. You are all fine soldiers, and no one can deny your courage. But our soldiers have a weak point. You like to fix the bayonet right away. For heaven's sakes, use the cannon and the rifle first. Then let the bayonet take over. Unless you are told so, no one will attack. You better keep this well in mind. Up, 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 up. You sit down. As you see, they have more ammunition than we have. They've been swimming in a plenty all their lives. When you fire a single shot, the machine gun returns plenty of rounds back. It's been so since our arrival in here, and so it has been.
Hey, you here, get up. What's your name?
Kazim, son of Ahmed.
Married or single?
I am married.
Birthday?
97.
Sit down. You young man?
Shaheen, son of Hussein.
Are you married?
No, sir.
Your birthday?
95.
Sit down.
Hey, you. I'm talking to you, kid. Get up. What are you stuffing your mouth for? Come on, tell me.
Well, I was just hungry. Everybody is having hazelnuts, and I'm having some plain bread.
I should stuff yourself.
I'm Mehmet. I was born in 1897, and I'm a bachelor.
No wonder no one would give you his daughter. Sit down.
Why shouldn't they give me their daughter?
Oh, all right, told...
all right.
Will
all right.
You permit me to say something? Don't interfere.
Well, how did this happen?
Well, sir, I don't know. Kelowan grabbed me when I least expected.
I don't believe it. Well, let's see you try.
Thank you.
Bravo, Kelowan.
Go ahead and kiss his hand.
There you are, boys. Step back.
Gentlemen, landing will begin today, on April the 25th, 1915, at 5:45 p.m. with the artillery fire of our fleet. The 29th Division will land at Sedul Bahir, and three brigades from the Major General Bridgewood's Corps at Aribunu. Kabatepe is the first offensive. We'll occupy the bridgeheads completely. A battalion of the 1st French Division will land at Kumkale. The Naval Division and the rest of the French Division will hold fake landings at Saras and Bessiglère. Good luck, gentlemen.
Sir General, the enemy infantry landed in between Aribunu and Kabatepe, occupying the hills within 1.5 kilometers. 27th Regiment keeps the enemy busy within 800 meters at the eastern. I've started attacking the enemy through his complete left flank from within 600 meters. I've also informed General Lemon. This is for your information.
You made a great decision that will affect the whole battle of Dardanelles. God be with you. I do approve of your operation. Go ahead. Get me the division commander, Mustafa Kemal.
All right.
Back!
Sir, my commander is on the line, waiting for you.
...57th Regiment Commander Hussein Avni speaking. Commander, we are fighting against superior forces. Say casual. Are surrounded by the enemy. Half of my men are killed. We are attacking. Your sons of 57th are at your orders, sir.
I'm not ordering you to attack. I'm ordering you to die. Until we die, our main forces and their commanders will gain time to replace our position.
Thank you. You sure arrived when we needed you most. Our friend here, the German sister, will brief you on your work and tell you exactly what you must do.
Sister. Sister.
Bury this locket with me.
Come over here.
Yes,
now run and tell the priest that we've just shipped it. Hey, now get on with it.
Yes, master. Father, Uncle Dmitri sent me to inform you that today we shipped 1,500 loaves more for the soldiers.
So, they sent another decennial by your front. Aleko, come and see me at the church. I will give you a letter. Take it to General Stanley again, with my regards.
Yes, sir.
Sergeant, pick yourself two platoons and report back for orders.
Yes, sir, Captain.
As I told you before, your duty is the detection of enemy outposts and the safety of our flank. After the village, we'll be in a dangerous area. It is occupied. Be cautious. Every bush might be sheltering an enemy. Crossing the village, we'll keep close distance. Now, move!
For 5 minutes.
Ah, welcome, son, welcome.
Allow me to kiss.
Bless you. Sama, dear, bring some iron for the sergeant.
Yes, father.
Don't bother, please.
Oh, nothing, son. Wish we could do better. All we can offer is iron. Do you have enough ammunition?
Aren't you ask, old one? Do you need some?
We don't, son, but we could give you some.
You mean you've got ammunition?
Yes, you just come with me.
Bless you. Thank you.
Give some to the other ones also.
Bless you.
Good girl. The other day, you really kicked the enemy out of their boots. They sure left a hell of a lot behind. We picked all the ammunition and weapons and stored. Then a way might come in handy.
Good work, old man.
Who's there?
Me. Me, my girl. This is Zeynep Gwaring.
Hello, sister.
Welcome, Sergeant.
Good to meet you.
One should keep an eye on the stuff. You never know. Can you use some of them?
And how?
In that case, take them with you.
On our way back, we'll take them with us. Guard them well, Zeynep.
I sure will, Sergeant.
Let's take you with us.
Where will you take us?
Well, this is by the front. There may be ambushes. It will be safer there.
Listen to me, son. World or cripple, well placed in the battlefield.
We're ambushed. Both of you run and tell Captain Doyen that we will keep them busy. Come on, fast, my boy!
Commander Mustafa Kamal, Captain Doan speaking, sir. I am just informed of a new enemy attack developing through the hills of Aribunu. I am leaving immediately with my men.
Zeynep, Major, we won. We still have our village.
Why, Alekka, is our bread ready yet?
If my outfit is ready, so is your bread, Uncle Pehlivan.
It's all yours. Now let's see how handsome you are.
Great, Uncle Petlivan.
Where are you going off to so fast?
I'll be back soon.
Thanks, Dimitri.
Welcome, old boy. Your bread will be ready in 10 minutes, and it's well baked today. Mm. It'll all be ready pretty soon. Mm. Marika, bring a thick cup of coffee for Pelivan.
Holy Father, I finally got the outfit we were waiting for.
With this outfit, you will look like a Turk, Aleko. No one will suspect you.
Holy Father, aren't we all Turks anyway?
No, my son. This was our country once. Someday soon, we will have it back, Aleko.
You should not be telling such things to a child. We are religious people. We should not be worrying about politics. We are living on this land and enjoying its privileges. So we are children of this country. No matter what your name is, Aleko, Dimitri, or Yanni, we are Turkish citizens.
We never agree on anything anyway. For this reason, we will ask the Patriarch for your transfer to another church. I will also inform him that you are denying your origin and betraying our religion.
Yours is the greatest treason. Treason to your own country.
Look, Aleko. Now is the time for the bomb. Shell Stavro prepared it for us. It is made so that it explodes 20 minutes after it is wound up. Now listen to me. Your duty is to drop it through the window of the ammunition store I showed you yesterday. It is the largest ammunition store of the Turks. When it blows up, they will be short of ammunition. And then our troops will attack immediately. I hope you understand the importance of your duty. Don't get caught. And God go with you. Isn't Aleko back yet?
No.
People are waiting at the church.
Let them wait. I'm busy now.
You should be fulfilling your duties to God. Instead of taking part in some dark, underground business with a bunch of ugly characters.
I'm an idealist, Kiriaki.
What you call idealism is treason to your country. And someday, you'll be punished for it.
Where is Aleko, I wonder?
Oh, he is not arrested.
We will all be ruined. They will execute us. Aleko. Did you blow up the ammunition?
Aleko? What Aleko? Aleko is dead. I am Ali.
You are crazy.
You are the crazy one, dear father. I am a Turk, son of a Turk. I learned all about it. My father and mother, they were both Turks. You did everything to me, but you could not change my blood.
We should kill this traitor.
You are too late, dear Holy Father. Here, take your toy back.
It's working!
Ships located at Morto Harbor are firing tons of ammunition onto our front in Kerevizdere. Our losses are very heavy and Kerevizdere has become a river of blood.
Just received orders to sink those enemy ships which are anchored in Marto Bay and which have turned the Kerevizdere into a stream of blood with their firepower. This gigantic ship, Goliath, is defended by those four powerful fighters. We are going to take care of this gigantic English battleship with our small vessel. I don't think we will return alive. And I can say now that we should consider the Bay of Morto as our grave. Friends, our ship should become part of the darkness. As your commander, I bid you goodbye as the old travelers of death. God bless you.
God bless you.
Marai Darbe.
Yes, sir.
Now you go and tell the fact to your men. Complete the preparations. God be with us, friends.
This will be my last letter to you. Tonight we have an important job to do. God bless you.
engines slow speed ahead.
Off engines slow speed ahead.
Starboard 1-5.
Starboard 1-5.
Port engines half speed forward.
Port engines half speed forward.
Starboard 1-5.
Starboard 1-5.
Starboard 1-5.
Starboard 1-5.
Get the torpedoes ready.
Asking for the password.
You ask back the same. Keep him busy. We should gain time.
He insists, sir. What's our reply?
For the password. Full speed ahead.
Full speed ahead. Full speed ahead, sir.
Mark to port.
Mark to port.
Get the torpedoes ready to fire.
Torpedoes ready to fire, sir.
Torpedo number one, attention, ready to fire.
Torpedo number one, attention, ready to fire.
Hard to port.
Hard to port.
Bismillah. Number one, fire. Number two, attention, fire! Number three, attention, fire! Full speed ahead.
Full speed ahead.
Course 5-5. Do not. Steady ahead.
Hard to port. Course 5-5.
No, to port. Straight ahead. Operator. Now send this message. Mission accomplished. Goliath is sinking into the blue waters of Dardanelles.
Donnelly, why are we digging all this time?
Remember the enemy lines just in front of us, where we lost hundreds of lives to capture? Well, we're just under them. We're going to explode it.
Now I see. Then our army will attack and capture it.
Yeah. You guys cut the cackling and hand me that line.
Yes, sir.
us were first.
Not only men, but the barrels are also lost underwater.
They shoot them.
I really can't wait. That thirst is worse than the battle, that's what it is.
Come, there is some left here.
Not that, Hassan. That's your share, that's yours.
There's a way out, but how?
Way out, but how?
Hey, Mehmet.
Yes, brother.
Why don't you try? If you could bring some water back, God will bless you.
If the captain permits, I sure would like to try it.
I'll now go and talk to the captain.
Sound. Go on, don't stop. The enemy is right here. Look, Cumber, if we have to return without water, neither you or I will be very happy. Come on, Cumber, come on. Let's go. Don't make a sound. Come on, boy.
Here, Cumber. Half is yours, and the other half is mine. Let's go. Don't be stubborn. You're acting like a donkey. Come on.
Stop that, will you? Leave me alone. I said leave me alone. Don't treat me like that. Stop it.
What kind of guys are you? Why don't you leave me alone and take me to your officer? I want to go to your officer and tell him my story. Come on, you guys. Leave me alone.
Who is this?
We've just captured a Turkish soldier with his donkey.
Bring him in. What is this? What are you doing here? First tell him to get that gun away.
Go.
Sir, the captain sent me here from the trench across. He knew you were suffering with thirst.
You don't have water, but we have plenty.
My captain is a true gentleman. He told me to take these barrels of water to you because he said we could not find an enemy suffering with thirst.
How will you return then?
Well, my captain said my return depended you as a gentleman.
I see you have a true gentleman and a good sportsman for an officer. We are glad to accept your water that he sent. Your kindness is well known. Sorry my men treated you so badly. You are injured. Let them take care of you.
No. I'll take care of it myself.
It is serious and deep. Let them clean it and put some stitches in it. Take him to the hospital.
Did he show up yet?
No, Captain.
Where the heck is he? There was some shooting last night. I wonder.
fight, then we cannot look for him.
Mehmet will surely turn up.
I hope so.
How is our Turkish soldier?
He's still sleeping, Doctor.
Well, that's good. Let me know when he wakes up.
Good morning. How are you?
Fine, thanks. You're so kind to me.
I grew up in Istanbul. I was there for 15 years. Exactly 15 years, at Kadıköy, Moda.
Did I sleep too much?
A few hours. Our men have been rough on you. We're ashamed. The general and the colonel, they all ask after your health.
I'm ashamed. What have I done?
It is unheard of kindness for one to send water to his enemy knowing his thirst. Only Turks could do such kindness.
I should be going now, sister.
No, you lost blood and you had a little surgery. You're weak.
You're so kind, sister. Sister.
Don't call me sister. My name is Lona.
Mine is Mehmet.
Now sleep a while. Maybe you'll see angels in your dreams.
I see angels while I'm awake. Where are you going, leaving me?
I have to visit others. I'll be coming back again soon. Today, Lona?
I feel better.
Anything you want?
No, thank you.
When the tent collapsed, were you scared?
We don't know the meaning of that word, miss.
Why are you looking at me like a stranger?
We're not relatives, and there's the battle.
Yes, we're not related.
Nothing to it. I was saving my life and happened to take you along.
Tell me something. Are you married? Or engaged?
Well, something like that. How can I not? She's so beautiful and pretty.
I'm curious. How did you meet? Or did your mother find her for you, according to your custom?
Neither. Actually, she found me.
Do you love her so much?
It was one day before I was transferred to Çanakkale. I was taken to a very rich mansion. When I inquired about our visit, they did not say anything. I had never seen such a luxurious house before in my whole life.
Welcome, son.
Glad to be here.
Sit down, son. Sit next to me. And tell me, where are you coming from and going to?
Coming from home. I'm just drafted. We had training. Now, tomorrow we'll be shipped to Çanakkale.
What would you do if you could just stay out of it?
I would still go. My father and brother have both died on the battlefields.
Don't you have anyone else?
Only a mother.
Are you married or single?
I'm a bachelor.
Someone you promised or you love?
No, never had a chance.
Son, I like you. I sure would like to get you married. And no need lying. I would love to marry off my daughter to you. This house has 30 rooms. Property, wealth, carriages, horses, servants, everything. Our income will take care of both of you all your life.
Why are you so nice to me?
She saw you while you were at training. Heart of a young girl. She wants you, nothing but you. Now call Mehmet's fiancé.
You know my name too.
Certainly. It is all arranged. You will be married right away.
How can you marry off your daughter to someone you don't even know?
I had enough investigation to find out. You are a nice chap. Tell me if you like my daughter.
I better be going now.
What are you trying to do? Don't you want her?
No.
Oh, my poor child. Get him. Look what you have done. Get him. See the trouble you have caused.
Look, Mother. You saw a young GI and figured you could sell anything to this poor man. I try not to say this, not to embarrass your girl. But you asked for it. Now, leave me alone.
Go away, man.
Get out of my way. Get out, I said. So that was that.
Do you know what I think?
Well, what is it, Lona?
A few more days and you'll be well and you'll depart. We may never see each other again.
One never knows, sister. Wait till the battle is over. You will always be a sister to me, Lona. Oh, come there! Come there! My beautiful come there! Where did you come from? What is this?
These are for your officers.
We don't sell water.
These are not in exchange for the water, just some gifts.
If we hurt you, we didn't mean to. Do forgive us. You brought water to us. You saved our sister from burning alive. Now take the friendly hand of your enemy and please take our respects and regards to your officers who sent you here. My most sincere wish is to have the brave Turkish nation as our friend, not enemy.
Dostum.
Now goodbye, soldier. Until you reach safely there, we will not fire.
Thank you, sir. I'll report all this to my captain.
Goodbye.
Attention!
We made it, Camber. Let's go. I wonder if the captain is angry.
Don't like this silence.
Yes, sir. After every silence, something new pops up. Here comes Kenola, sir.
He must have lost his mind. He jokes as if it's nothing.
Open the wire.
Gazem, Halit, Osma, Mahmud, move!
I'm here, sir.
Stupid one, they're going to shoot you.
But they promised.
They're going to shoot you, I'm telling you.
They will not fire until I'm back. English captain said so.
What are all these, Kalawan?
Presents from the enemy.
Where the hell have you been?
Well, there was an artillery fire and we rolled into the English trenches with Kander. Then there was no way out and I made up a story.
telling them you had sent the water over and because we could not fight the thirsty enemy. They thanked me and sent you these beautiful presents.
Pull him in here. Give him the works. Prepare for punishment.
Come here!
With your permission, may I say something?
Go ahead.
He was like a son to me. If his mother hears he has done something wrong and been beaten for it, she will die of shame. Permit me. Permit me to take his place, Captain.
Get him up. Release his feet. A Turkish soldier does not lie.
The Turkish soldier does not lie, sir. But he lies to the enemy.
God save your soul!
My dear friends, the operations of the Dardanelles has already cost us too much. We can get the final result by applying such a plan. The main attack will be held by the Anzac Corps, and the point of attack is Anafartalar. The three incoming divisions will land at Sulva under the command of General Stoffer and the Turks from the north. In order to cover this operation, we will land 300 Greek soldiers on the north of Saros Bay under the command of Lieutenant Griparisi and keep the Turks occupied with this force. To victory!
Told Sanders should show some patience. If he is not satisfied with the results of tomorrow's battle, he should hold me responsible.
Was tut Sanders das?
Das habe ich auch nicht verstanden.
Colonel Fersibay, from this time on, I'm turning over the responsibilities and command to him as the Anafartalar Group Commander. I order your transfer to Istanbul upon the arrival of Mustafa Kemal Bey. Would you accept such command? I'm assigned as the Anafartalar Group Commander. I order an immediate attack of the 12th Division from the direction of Meslantepe and the 7th Division from Damakçık Hills. Commanders should immediately inform me of their stations and positions. The reports will be sent to Çamlı Hill. Anafartalar Group Commander Mustafa Kemal.
Men, an noticed an activity over the enemy trenches at night, but we were not able to find out what they were up to. Sergeant Cardew will lead you to the enemy trenches. There you will connect our telephone wires to the English switchboard.
Ready yet?
I wonder why they select you for such jobs.
Well, Sergeant, I happen to know the area very well.
Not only that, you can outsmart a fox. Know what you should do?
Perfectly.
First, we'll crawl to the English trenches. There, I'll attract the attention of the guards. Then you'll sneak in the trench.
What are you going to do?
Don't worry about that. I can take care of myself. Come, let's move.
You forgot your pipe.
You know I don't smoke.
Many Englishmen do. Can you imagine an Englishman without a pipe?
All right.
Now you look like an Englishman.
Good luck, son.
Move that way. You jump into the trench.
But, Sarge, you're gonna die.
Your mission is no less dangerous.
No, Sarge, don't try that way.
That's an order.
Yes, Sarge.
Haven't you got the commander yet?
Unfortunately.
Call Smith for me now.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
understand, sir. Yes, sir.
Of course. I'll be glad to.
This is WVO. New supplies will arrive tomorrow afternoon.
Dirty dog, I would kill you right away, but unfortunately we need you. Kellerman returned. He is injured. He brought in a wounded English officer with him.
What, an English officer?
Yes, sir.
Send both of them to the field hospital immediately. I will inform the captain.
Aye, sir.
Alan?
Sister, our Kellerman is injured. Please give him the best place.
Take him to tent number 5.
How are you, Corporal Mehmet?
Which corporal, Captain?
Last night you were in the rank of a corporal. I hope you soon get to be a sergeant.
Please, Captain, can you tell these sisters to leave me alone? I want to go back to the front.
Well, patience, my boy. Well, patience, my boy. How do you feel, Ismirli?
Well, thanks, Captain.
Don't mention it.
That damn machine gun, it took care of the others, and then it was my turn.
Very list. Each
this last year.
So she is your girl. Then why was she crying when I left? You, why did you squeeze my hand when I held it? I must be a fool. A dumbhead. I go and fall in love with an enemy girl. If my mother heard of this, if my captain knew this, he would spit on my face.
Sergeant.
Very soon the battle is going to be over.
Where did you hear this?
They heard the British talk on the wire that Kelloland said. Oh yes, they're leaving soon.
Well, well, well. Well, let them go as they have arrived. This means we get home soon.
This damned machine gun. I'm taking over.
Lieutenant Cudley was a victim too. We tried hard, but no success.
They sure picked a fine position for us here. It's impossible to move without losing half of the men.
So what can we do, Captain?
Well, here we are together again. It seems that we can never depart from each other. To tell you.
Come over here. What do you want to say?
You're engaged.
How did you know?
That's none of your business. I saw a picture you gave him. If you were engaged, why did you act so?
Would one make fun of someone after he had saved her life? Let's go over here. Tell me, is Charles alive?
Don't worry. He's alive.
How did you come here? Aren't you afraid? They might get you.
I couldn't care less.
Good evening, Lerna.
Good evening, Captain.
Tonight, some more badly wounded soldiers will arrive. Would you take care of them?
Yes, Captain, I will.
Thank you, Lerna.
Please leave now. If they get you, they'll kill you.
What do you care?
Do you have to talk so bitterly? Can't you see I'm in love with you?
If you're serious, I'm in love with you too.
You must go.
Bye now, Luna. I'll be seeing you.
I'll walk with you to the front line. Then they won't be suspicious.
I don't need a guard.
Don't forget me.
Oh my God, what happened to the bloody machine gun?
It must be one of Mehmet's tricks. How else could it turn around by itself?
Ah!
after your shot. Don't shoot.
Never shoot an injured enemy.
But he shot you.
He was doing his duty as a soldier.
Let's go to the hospital, Captain.
Margo, evacuation has been undertaken successfully. The ships are ready to depart.
Very well. Mankind has lost 550,000 lives in the Dardanelles, 300,000 of our forces and 250,000 of the Turks. What a shame. All we have learned is that the Dardanelles are impassable.
The land has no significance if the people living on it are not willing to die for it.